Welcome to a lesson on place value and whole numbers. The goals of this video are to define counting numbers and whole numbers, determine place value of whole numbers, and then write whole numbers in expanded form. In mathematics, there are different types or sets of numbers. The counting numbers, sometimes called natural numbers, are the set of numbers as we see here, and you can see why they're often called the counting numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on would be the numbers we use to count items. Now, whole numbers are the set of counting numbers and zero. So whole numbers are the numbers in the set as we see here, and again, the only difference is whole numbers include zero, while counting numbers don't. Since our number system is base 10, as we consider larger and larger counting or whole numbers, we have to introduce place value to distinguish between different quantities. For example, if we were counting these items where each square was 1, we'd have a total of 5, or 5 in the 1's place value, which gives us the number 5. However, if we wanted to count the total number of items here, we'd actually start to group them in tens, so we'd have a total of 3 groups of 10, so we'd have a 3 in the tens column to represent the 30, and then a 2 in the ones column to represent the remaining 2 items to represent the number 32. A 3 in the tens column and a 2 in the ones column. Now if we wanted to count the number of items we see here, once we counted 10 groups of 10, that would represent 100 items. So here we see 10 groups of 10, or 100 items, and then we have 5 groups of 10, or 50, so we have a 5 in the tens column, and then we have 3 left in the ones column to represent 153. Now let's take a look at a more comprehensive place value chart. So as we work our way from left to right using place value, we have the ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, hundred thousands, millions, 10 millions, 100 millions, and so on. One more thing, when writing large numbers, we separate the millions and the thousands with a comma, and the thousands and hundreds with a comma, to help keep the digits organized. Notice how in the place value chart I did include the decimal to the far right. Because we're not going to have any digits to the right of the decimal for whole numbers, we normally do not include the decimal point. But the reason I wanted to include it is the word and is used to represent the decimal point, so we shouldn't use and when we say whole numbers. So this would be 8,302,795. Sometimes you'll hear people say and, like 795, but technically that would not be correct. So if we wanted to practice identifying place values, this 3 would be in the 100,000s place value. The 2 would be in the 1,000s or thousands place value, and the 9 would be in the tens place value. Let's take a look at one more example of this. Let's go ahead and put the commas in to separate our place values, and starting from the right, we put a comma between every 3 digits here and here. So this would be 845,306,917. So this 4 would be in the 10 millions place value. The 5 would be in the 1 millions or millions place value. And the 7 would be in the ones place value. Now sometimes you'll be asked to write numbers in expanded form, and writing a number in expanded form is a way to emphasize the place value of each digit. What I mean by that is this 5 represents 500, this 8 represents 8 tens or 80, and this 3 represents 3 ones or 3. This is called expanded form of 583. So for 12,893, this 1 represents 1 10,000 or 10,000 plus 2 1,000s or 2,000 plus 8 would be 800 plus this 9 represents 90 and the 3 represents 3. For this 8, we have the thousands, millions, and billions. So this would be 8 billion plus Now, because there's a zero in the 100 millions place value, we do not need to include that. So we'll have plus 90 million plus 1 million plus, this would be 100,000. And the next non-zero digit is this 3, which represents 30, and then plus 2. Okay, the last thing we'll do is take a look at how we write whole numbers in English. We write a whole number in the same way that we say them using correct place value. We separate the number in words by commas the same way we do when we write the number. So for example, here we have 3,000, comma, 581. Here we have 10,025. Notice the comma between the 10,000 and the 25. And then here we have 12 million, comma, 81,000, comma, 972. Let's go and try a couple of our own. So we have 150,000 comma 112. Remember, we should not include the word and because the and represents a decimal point. In our last example, here we have the thousands, millions, and billions. So we have 15 billion, $85 million, $205,000, comma 123. And we're going to go ahead and stop here for this video. I hope you found this helpful.